In most SPSS databases, each row corresponds to a single case. For example, if the survey sample had 100 respondents, the database will have 100 rows. However, in some situations, the raw data we collect do not present the values for each case, but only the frequencies of these values. For example, in this table, we have the answers to a survey question. How satisfied are you with our product? The possible answers were very unsatisfied, somewhat unsatisfied, somewhat satisfied, and very satisfied. And the frequencies for each answer are in this column. So, 2 respondents were very unsatisfied, 8 respondents were somewhat unsatisfied, 19 respondents were somewhat satisfied, and 35 respondents were very satisfied. Well, in such conditions, we cannot create an usual database where each row represents one case. We must find a workaround for this. So we are going to define two variables in our database. The first one will contain the answers, and the second one will contain the frequencies. So let's create our variables. We go here in variable views. Let's call this first variable satisfaction. It's a numeric variable with zero decimals. Let's define the values now. We will code them with 1, 2, 3, and 4. So the value 1 will be very unsatisfied. Add. The value 2 will be somewhat unsatisfied. The value 3 will be somewhat satisfied. And the last value, the last code, 4, will be very satisfied. So these are the answer to our survey question. Okay, the measure for this variable is, of course, ordinal. Now let's define the second variable, frequency. It's also numeric with zero decimals. And the measure for this variable is, of course, scale. Now let's enter in our database the values in this table. So we go back in data view. For the value 1, very unsatisfied, the frequency is 2. For the value 2, somewhat unsatisfied, the frequency is 8. For the value 3, somewhat satisfied, the frequency is 19. And for the value 4, very satisfied, the frequency is 35. Now I'm going to show you a little trick. If you want to see the labels that hide behind these values, you must click this button here with A and 1. And you can see here the labels in clear. Very unsatisfied, somewhat unsatisfied, to very satisfied. If we want the program to show the value, the code again, we have to click this button again. It's a toggle button. Okay. Now we have to weight the variable satisfaction with the values of the variable frequency. We do it this way. In the data menu, we go here to weight cases. Now we select here the option weight cases by, then enter the frequency variable in this field. Press OK. You noted the mention here, weight on. So again, the variable satisfaction was weighted with the variable frequency. Let's build a table of frequencies for the variable satisfaction, just to make sure it's weighted. Well, we anticipate a bit here. We will learn how to create a table of frequencies in a future lesson. Now, very quickly, from the menu Descriptive Statistics, Frequencies, enter the variable satisfaction here and click OK. There's the frequency table. You can notice that here in the frequency column, we have the correct frequencies for each level of the variable satisfaction. Very unsatisfied 2, somewhat unsatisfied 8, somewhat satisfied 19, and very satisfied 35. So our variable is weighted. We can also use the weighting procedure when the raw data take the form of a cross table, like this one, for example. Here we have the number of preferences for three coffee brands, Lavazza, Don Cafe, and Jacobs, broken down by the respondents' gender. These are fictitious numbers, of course. So, 15 men prefer Lavazza, 35 men prefer Don Cafe, 42 men prefer Jacobs, etc. To enter this data in SPSS, I will define two variables, coffee brand and gender, plus a weighting variable. I will call it frequency. So, let's open a new file. And now let's create our variables. The first variable is coffee. So it's numeric with zero decimals. And the values are 1 for Lavazza, 2 for Don Cafe, and 3 for Jacobs. Okay, that's a nominal variable. Then the second variable is gender, also numeric, 0 here. And the values will be 1 for men and 2 for women. These are the codes I have chosen. Okay. And then the weighing variable, frequency, it's numeric with 0 variables. The measure here is scaled, and here for the variable gender, the measure is nominal 2. Great, let's come back to the data view. My database will have 6 cases corresponding to the 6 cells in this table. So, first of all, I will enter the men who like Lavazza here. So, men who like Lavazza. The frequency is, just a moment, 15. Okay. Then, again, the men who like Don Cafe. The frequency is 35. Then the men who like Jacobs. Oh, sorry. The frequency is 42. Now for the women. The women who like Lavazza. The frequency is 40. Women who like Don Cafe. Okay, the frequency is 30 here. And finally, women who like Jacobs, the frequency is 12. Okay. Now, all we have to do is to weight this database, the variables coffee and gender, with the frequency variable. Again, go to data, weight cases. Weight cases by, of course, frequency. Then press OK. Just a moment. And you can notice this mention here, weight on. Now let's build rapidly a cross table just to make sure our data is properly weighted. We will talk in detail about cross tabulation in a future lesson. Now very quickly, descriptive statistics, cross tabs. We will enter the coffee variable, for example, in the rows window, and the gender variables in the, no, sorry, we will do it just like in this table, just a moment, gender in the rows window and coffee in the columns window. Okay, and now we press OK. Please take a look at this cross table here. We notice that it has the same frequencies as in our initial table. So for the men we have 15, 35 and 42, and for women we have 40, 30 and 12. So now we can be sure that our cases have been weighted with the variable frequency. If we want to remove the weight to return to the initial status, we go again to data, weight cases, and select this option, do not weight cases, and then OK. Thank you. See you in the next lesson.